Welcome back.
Are we muted? Is that what that is?
No, we were muted until now.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Paul. Appreciate that. Paul waits till I sit down and put headphones on without looking at the screen, and then does the intro.
Okay. Welcome back. Oh, this is the top 8, not the top 16. My bad.
All right, I'll fill your dead air, Paul. Hi. Okay. Hello. This is Chris Allen, joined by Mr. Paul Heaver.
Hi.
We're in the top 8 of the Steel Open.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
You're not here because you didn't play. I'm not here because I'm bad.
On one side, we've got a double ARC 170 list, borrowed by John Proctor. He's one of the two rebels that made it to the top 8. We've got Nora with PTL Kyle BB-8 in the title. So Nora's got that whole like BB-8 like pre thing, clearing and getting an eyeball and PTLing. And
wants to be pre-nerf Whisper when she grows up.
Yeah, wants to be pre-nerf Whisper. Shara Bay has adaptability. I guess, yeah, you got no points left. Janor's R2-D2. And Jess Pava's R3-A2 prime thrusters and integrated.
Shara Bay's the one that you can give focus to other ships when they're only on their
target
attacking,
lock.
Right? Oh, target locks. Yeah. She's not the K-Wing. Okay.
Right. And then on the other side is a Mind Lake Fen Rao scouts list.
Am I allowed to say the real name on Aaron's stream?
You could say whatever you want, but it's wrong.
It's what?
It's wrong.
It's grassholes.
No. Oh, well, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to call it something with the crate in it.
No.
Okay.
Hello, chat. How are you? Okay, so I've got the other lists that are up in the top 8.
Oh, yeah.
So I didn't count the copies of Mind Link because the last game went long.
So that's what
so
we have
there's
here.
There's this matchup. There's Asajj Finn Old Tarok up against Fen Rao Double Scout. Grassholes.
Yep.
Paul, this list looks familiar. Yeah. Could you tell me about it?
Yeah, well, there is another rebel. The other rebel is my Naboo list.
Yep, against
Jeremy Howard.
Against Jeremy Howard. So Jeremy Howard, congrats on top 8. And we also have Fen Rao Asajj Manru. That fits.
Yeah, Fen Rao Asajj Manru.
All right, Mind Link, whatever you say, against Fen Double Scout.
Yep. Lots of Fen.
I'm listening to John's story.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. So they both brought the big rocks. What rocks does John have? Like, there's the biggest rock.
He had a big one and two medium-sized rocks.
He brought the middle finger, which if you're going to bring, if you want big rocks but not the biggest, the middle finger's strong because it's disrespectful.
Okay, so John has initiative.
Is it relevant? Yes, just pop in the skeletons. So, have you played against the Stress Jess? It's kind of cool.
No, I've never played against it.
I really like it. I mean, I would probably rather take a Stress Hog, but...
But I mean, with Prime Thrusters, you're still getting actions.
Yep.
I mean, it's only one action like that you get, but it's...
But against Mind Link, it's still 3 Stress a turn, and you can boost, so you can actually turn around, which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
The similar thing made it to Naboo's top... I don't know. It was on the top tables at the end of Naboo. I don't remember if it made the cut, but it was Jess with the Rebel Jank Rex Rourke type thing.
He's going to put the moon over there.
All right, let's see. Where's the middle finger going? Which way is it going to face?
Yeah. Who do you point the middle finger at?
Yes. It's always your opponent.
Oh.
There, oh, himself. Wow. That's incorrect, Frank. Oh, wait, Frank, is the thing backwards?
No.
Oh, the camera's on. All right, I've pieced it together.
Yeah, okay, you figured it out. Yeah, Frank made a newbie mistake pointing the middle finger at himself.
Yes,
but
rookie mistake.
Yeah.
It's all right, we'll inform him of his mistake if he wins. If not, we probably leave him alone.
Yeah. Okay.
So just Jess first, yep. Which is really unfortunate for Jess.
Yeah.
But that's a strong starting location. Those jump masters I mean, they don't really have to turn left.
Going to start where they always start.
Yep.
They always start in that corner on the side there.
Hey, I started my Jump Masters on the right side one game. I got 100-0'd.
The best way to deal with the scum list in general, stressing it is good, and bombing Fen Rao is good.
Yeah, have your opponent don't block your bomb, and then drop cluster bombs on Fen Rao.
Yeah.
Easy. Get a Stress Hog behind Fen Rao, that does it too.
Also, if you notice the paint job on John's lists. Yeah.
Oh, actually, one second, I'll be right back.
John has some really good paint job there.
You're missing great deployment action over there.
No, we do not have a link to the tournament list in the top 8. We, I don't know, maybe they'll end up in List Juggler at some point? I don't know. I'm sure to commentate. Anytime you kill a Fen with cluster bombs, an angel gets its wings. So, it looks like Frank's gonna hold out on the top there.
Don't worry, the commentator you really wanted here is back.
Okay.
Coordinating rides back to North Carolina as we scrub out.
Mm. Man, Marcus, you're so negative.
Yeah, Marcus, if you play, both of these ships can really like play the I'll be in range one of one scout and out of arc of the other game pretty well. Especially with the way those rocks are set up. We'll see if John is able to drag Frank through this. I don't think Frank is going to fall for it. He's a better grass holes player than I. Frank talking about food.
Yep.
Shocker. So actually, John said this is his first stream game. Which is it's actually pretty relevant because the first one you're nervous for.
Yeah.
I mean, Paul, I don't know. Let's go way back in time to your first stream game. Do you even remember it, honestly?
That would be against
in the dark when dinosaurs were still roaming the lands.
No, well, it'd be in 2013, I think, during the top four against Jonathan Gomez.
Mm-hmm.
Or Gomes? Whatever.
At Worlds, right?
At Worlds, yeah. I think that would be the first time I was on stream.
Make you nervous?
You think you played? I don't think I was that nervous. Like,
gotcha. All right, never mind. Yeah. Anecdote ruined. Thanks, Paul.
Yeah, sorry.
That's cool.
I mean, I was probably more nervous than, like, the Worlds.
Yes, that it was top four at Worlds.
Yeah, the finals at Worlds especially, like, I was super nervous.
That game wasn't close. What do you mean? John talking about how he's not good at this game and is in fact really lucky.
So do you think they just both smush each other? Like,
I think just, John would be very happy if that's what happened, because there's no way those Torp Scouts get through there and get good shots through those rocks. The deployment for John's kind of interesting, with Jess in the middle. Do you know which arc is which?
They have the same pilot skill now,
mm-hmm.
thanks to adaptability.
Yes, but the bottom one's Nora, I think. Is that a 7? Yeah, so the bottom one's Nora, the top one's Shara.
Okay, I'll,
I think that's correct. Yeah, that's a 6 for sure.
Okay, so that's Shara on top, so I'll 6 that. Shara is the dark
yeah, the top one. Oh, okay. You people in your color vision...
Okay.
Ron immediately goes to play Destiny.
Oh, yeah, short and tall. That's even better.
I like short and tall.
Short and tall is the best. Shara is a short.
Yep. Yeah, Frank is running at 98 with no Boba Fett. We were talking about this on Friday, I guess.
Yeah, Terp Scout is running at 98 points, no Boba Fett.
Oh, shut up, Budget Nathan. I did get a win. I got 3 wins at this tournament, and I only played 5 games.
Yep.
So if you're, let's say you're Frank this game, how do you open up here? Are you going to just blast down the right side of the board and try to come in behind?
I don't know if I know.
I could never get my mind in a rebel player's head because I look at ships jousting each other and immediately panic and die inside.
Yeah,
so.
I'm like, if I was Frank, I would just point my ships at the enemy ships and shoot missiles at them. I mean, it's
3-time world champion Paul Heuer, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Well, what are you gonna do? I got missiles and he doesn't. I'll just use them, right? It's fine.
Sven boats is a thing. By the way, Bob, way to just spam Fen boats in our Vassal League. I see you doing that.
You mean grass holes.
Row boats.
Yeah, Bob, there were a lot of variations. I did Boba Proton at 99 and dropped an extra munitions for an intel agent, like you said. But 98, I assume, is one Frank some games. I hit some mirrors at 99, and I'm good at rolling initiative dice, mm-hmm. So it was fine. But yeah, Frank is the lowest in the top 32 from what I saw. At
yeah, he's the biggest bid out of the top 32.
Were there any Kanan bigs anywhere?
Not in the top 32.
Nova players, good at X-Wing, don't play Kanan bigs. Interesting.
Kanan bigs is a fine list. Why have we not started yet?
That's a good
Tony,
question.
Why have we not started yet?
Tony, why are you wearing the wrong shirt?
I don't actually know. Why haven't we started? Waiting for somebody?
Because Jeremy's hurled up crying in a corner that he's hit your list, Paul.
They're waiting to get people set up. Did you get towed?
What?
Did you get towed?
No. Thankfully. Unless it's gone again, in which case I don't know.
I was surprised to learn that.
I mean, to be fair, Bob, you should probably run strong lists at the deep core level, but yeah.
How's your deep core run going?
I'm like 3 and 4.
The dream.
Yeah.
I'm running it up.
I'm running some experimental lists.
It's a very weird way to spell bad.
Is there Josh Holt still playing in the cut? There might have been. So. I think he's still in it. He's that one? No? No, not.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, Josh Holt is still in.
Josh is playing against a person who's friends with Josh, Finn Rao, Old Tarok, and Asajj. Who is Gabe Taylor. Jeremy already calling a judge to try to DQ his opponent to have any chance in his game. If you Bobo the Ghost title, you're bad, so don't do that, Alex.
Bobo.
If you Bobo the Ghost title, I don't know what happens.
If you Boba the Twin Laser Turret, then it's a lot easier for everybody involved and you don't have to call the judge over.
Yes,
so do that
and then
instead.
The judge doesn't call you an idiot.
Well, the judge wouldn't do that. Be nice.
If I'm the judge, he might.
Depends on what round it is. But
yeah, if you're in the cut, he might call you an idiot. No, Chase couldn't make it to steal. So, I think Chris, T.O. Chris, is really trying to make it just fill as much dead air as possible here.
Yeah. Okay, they're shaking.
There we go.
Today we're starting.
Oh, shocker.
This is the powerful rebel opening of one forward.
What do you do? I don't know. What are you going to do? All right, I'm going to call Frank's move. 4 straight.
2 turn.
Barrel roll, 2 turn. Focus, Finn Rao, 1 turn, barrel roll left. Calling it now. Okay, 1/3 of the way there.
Okay, so far so good. This is where Frank, let's see.
The barrel roll is questionable. The focus is also strong.
No, he's focused in the world.
Okay, all right. You win this round, Frank.
No, it's Frank using the mod cubes.
Are they paying us money? Should we promote them?
No, they're not.
They're terrible. Not, don't use
they're
them.
They're not an official sponsor, so we're not promoting them more than normal, other than just saying, hey, it's an interesting thing. Meanwhile, for your needs, feel free to go to Crafted Storage, Ned Ash's thing, and,
yeah,
and get some Crafted
Storage.
Where did
Ned finish up? Did he make the cut? I think he did, right?
He made the cut. He was knocked out. I think he was knocked out. I don't remember. One forward.
The dream. He can't one forward again next turn, though.
Yeah.
So,
there's a rock there. What are you doing?
There's a challenge link somewhere.
Yeah,
hey, Travis,
like
listener.
Justin got it. Justin has it.
Oh, okay.
There.
It's
yeah.
in there. Well, listener, go put the challenge link in chat again so that the people have it. A three turn. Oh, man, I'm so bad. I'm wrong.
Well, that's because there's no barrel rolls involved, so you
yeah.
do a three turn instead.
Frank, treating Finral like Finral. Well, I'm going to point him at you, and we'll see what happens.
Yep. We'll see where this goes.
It's like, in one of my games, I took Finn Rao into range one in arc of a Nora who had five hull left, and he goes, let's see who Finn Rao likes more, me or you. It was me.
Nice. Oh, yeah. BB-8 on Nora means he can get out of that.
Yes, okay, so he can still one straight.
Yeah.
Well, he's good.
We can keep doing one straight for at least another like two turns.
Like three. Oh no, he'll get middle. Frank's middle finger rock is outplayed his one straights. Do you know what camera this is, by the way?
Aaron Utley's camera.
All right. Deep.
Yes. Some HD camera that he has, like some
yeah.
fancy thing.
I need to get one
it's
for
super
Worlds
sharp.
If they're not super expensive.
Yeah, look how sharp this stuff is.
It's super good. Like, I don't know what his bit rate is, but it's good. chat, the Hot Co-Pilots are great promos. I'm not going to go plug all our local stuff on Aaron's stream, though. You can message me, I'll answer all of those questions.
We will, however, plug, what's another sponsor?
Curled Paw.
Curled Paw, yeah.
They are actually making the Crate 2.0 templates, which is exciting.
Nice.
So as you 100-0 podcasters who are bad, you can get those.
Yeah.
Where's the storage boxes? Crafted Storage? Or they were Curled Paw, right?
Yeah.
For Destiny? That's a stupid question for Paul. I'll give the credit to Curled Paw, because they're next on the sponsor list.
Yeah.
Y'all dropped it under the table over there when y'all were screaming about Epic.
Sorry.
I mean, the camera we're using here is amazing.
Yeah, it's so good. I doubt we can get a camera this good that matters with the, like, Wi-Fi or the phone.
Well, the key thing actually isn't so much the camera, it's those light boxes.
Yes.
Like, those light boxes are amazing.
And I do not think FFG will let us put those on the random Swiss tables at Worlds.
No.
For some reason.
No. Are those boxes work cold, Paul? Okay, awesome. The stuff going on that you can't see, there's a couple other games and some other games.
Merrick's Marauders is happening.
Yeah. Yeah, the lighting is really the key thing that makes the stuff look good. So that you can tell what the dice rolls are and everything.
So, Paul, it looks like both players are Rebel players at heart.
Yep.
And just going to run down this one lane and joust each other.
Yep, just punch each other in the face. That's how we roll.
I can't handle a judge being named Chris. Everyone yells Chris all the time. Two turns. Ooh. I'm not sure that's legal with Rebel ships.
No, remember the Y-Wing only does two turns.
That's
the
fair.
Only thing he knows how to do.
That's fair. Sometimes you can 4K as well. Once.
Once. You get to do it once per game. Uh-oh.
Oh, now it's moved.
Well, you pushed it a little bit.
Frank keeps knocking it back. You can't target. I don't know what happened. You can't target lock me, though.
You couldn't target lock, but we could shoot each other. wait, what? Okay, well, I guess we're not doing crazy BB-8 things.
Yeah. I just love the wall of arc wings. It looks like a World War II fighter formation.
Yeah.
And Fen Rao is going to flank, to everyone's surprise.
Yep.
So probably just the
boost.
Yeah, the boost left.
So like a side boost so they can make a big turn next turn. Yeah.
So Nora is the one in the bottom with BB-8.
Nora
right?
is tall, yes.
Nora is the tall one. So Shara doesn't really have great ways to avoid getting at least one torpedo next turn. Maybe two. Does that three bank right fit, do you think, for Shara?
For Shara?
I doubt it.
No.
The two bank is iffy. And she doesn't have vector thrusters, right? No.
Yeah.
So you can't, like, two turn, barrel roll, block one, eat one torp, and then go regen it.
I mean, you could three bank the other way and just point your butt arc out.
That's true.
Yeah.
What is Craft the Storage email address? I don't know. Why would we know that?
We'll plug the sponsors, but we won't, like, memorize all
their. I'm not going to go Google their email address for you. We talk about what Frank's going to do next turn, but there's absolutely no question.
Yeah.
The U-boats are doing some combination of one or two straight and one or two banks.
Yep.
And Fen Rao is going to two or three turn.
Yep.
And Fen Rao is going to focus. But what does John do? I don't know. I don't play these ships. Do you play these ships, Paul?
I haven't played Arcs, actually. I'm kind of curious what he ends up doing here.
Like, in this situation, I'm Frank. I'm hungry, right? Like, this is like, I'm in. Let's do this.
Yeah. Let's shoot a billion missiles at Shara.
Because if he one straights that top jump master, he can sloop the next turn, which is disgusting.
Mm-hmm.
And then torpor again, because they both have extra munitions.
I don't know. I'd consider doing the two forwards,
yeah.
And then do like a three bank with the other
one. That's just barely out of range. So a two bank is good enough to get torp range. Right, because like range 3 was like here.
Range 3 was just shy.
But it's a little iffy because that's like a one bank distance, I think.
Yeah, two banks probably all you need.
And what? I don't know how John Proctor wins this game, and not because I don't think he's going to win it, but because
you just don't know.
I can't joust things. As we've all seen, what happens when I try to play jousting lists.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe he just points at Fen, like does a two right. Oh, I hate that move. No.
Yeah, no. Because if
Fen's doing like a three turn.
Yeah, and then Fen's like range 3 one shots. That's fine, whatever. Yeah. And in return, you get two torpedoes into Shara. I'm in.
I mean, maybe the right answer is a three left bank with Shara.
Yep.
Just to avoid his. And if you are getting torpedoed, then you have a rock between you and.
And it. You get two dice.
And you still are firing your butt shot at Fen to
yeah.
be a little bit annoying.
I don't think you'll have range, will you? If that's range 3 and you 3 bank and he 3 turns. I don't know. It would be auto thrusters, too.
Oh, yeah. And either way, Jess has to go first, so we'll see what she's doing.
Jess will probably tell us what's happening here. Oh, we're going for the honorable joust. That doesn't answer our question at all.
That doesn't answer what the other ones are doing at all, but we're having an honorable joust with Jess.
Jess Pava. Send a letter to your family, Jess.
You could just do a two left turn with Shara Bay.
I'm out.
Peace.
There's the two.
Mm-hmm. So
Jess,
target lock?
Safe from torpedoes.
The back one.
Ooh, Frank.
Frank probably thinks he's going to get in range 1 from the other one. So
yeah, and this one can't regen. Yeah. All this damage is permanent.
Yeah.
And there's no way that ship isn't in arc, right? You could.
Yeah.
like
there's no way it's going to get
two
away.
Bank right BB-8 roll right two bank over the rock like the no. So is it the two bank? It's the two bank. And would you go for the lock on Sherry here? Yeah, no.
He's getting jazzed. Yeah, the ships that are permanent damage, he's locking first.
It feels like a losing bet, though, because when you put half... When you strip all the shields off of that, you have to keep shooting it. But if you don't, then it's that regen ship versus the rest of your list.
If I could take it.
Oh. That is close. Oh, my God. Everyone clench. Let's just keep bumping everything. And he clears it. Saying he's glad he doesn't look like a dork on stream.
Yep. So Shara Bay grabs a target lock.
Yep. At BB-8 time.
So here comes BB-8 shenanigans.
Barrel roll. And it's green. I didn't see what the maneuver is. I assume it's a two bank.
A one bank, I think it's a green one.
Oh.
Oh, nope, two bank, yep. See, I don't even know what the green maneuvers are for the arc.
Paul.
Which gives him... Cal time. Turns out to evade.
And I still get an action. Target
we should,
lock.
We should target lock the other way.
Yeah, there you go. That jump master is about to get lit up.
Yes.
If John is even mediocre at rolling dice.
Yeah. Okay. R2. He's not going to get in range 1.
No, I mean, he has to focus.
He has to focus, yeah.
As much as you want to boost here, you have to focus.
Yeah.
The focus gives you 5 actions. It's pretty good.
See, now this is when it would have been interesting if he did turn in towards Fenrau, because...
Yeah, Fenrau would be dead.
Yeah, you just light Fen up instead. Range 2, all he has is a focus.
Yep. But had that happened, presumably the back jump master would have focused, then Fen can boost.
Two shields on Jess. Jess should have rolled an extra die. Yep. Spend it.
Oh yeah,
yeah,
there it is.
Just reroll.
Going for the 5 and 8. Oh, made his situation worse. I'm glad that the way we've been tracking health and shield has been inconsistent every round. As long as it's different every time, it's
different
fine.
Every round.
Really?
What?
Oh, to add a focus.
Oh, to add a focus. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, see, there it is.
We totally know how these ships work. We're not just like, what? What's going on?
Oh, contracted scout pretending to be a Z-95. That's very big. Now he has the focus. Well, he won't have the focus for another target lock later, but... Wow.
Or we'll just roll 4. Three.
Will he spend? That's a real decision to make.
That is. So he spent his eyeball?
Yep.
You have to actually remove the eyeball from the...
Yeah. Well, is that... This ship's... I don't know. I don't know where the top ship's like tokens are. Probably behind it. We just can't see.
Yeah. And Jess has 2 rerolls.
Yep. And a focus.
Everybody gets a stress thanks to Jess being a mean.
Oh.
Oh, boo.
That's still a world of hurt for this jump master. Oh. Dice eventually average out, as it turns out.
Okay. So, front scout is down to two hull.
Will Jess survive?
Back guy at Jess.
Oh!
See how good you are at rolling dice the second time, Frank. Frank, get it together. Frank. Only three, embarrassing.
Only three, only three.
Frank, you spent that focus. You are.
You spent the front focus, Frank.
Oh.
Two hits. So Jess is into hull. It's a console fire, not a blind pilot. So he's shooting the ordnance at the back person. Let's see if he remembers that he already spent that focus.
Nope.
He should have one more damage. Two on tall. What do they start with? They're 6'3", right?
Yes, Paul, they're 6'3".
Those were some really amazing dice.
The chat would like scout hull descriptions. I believe one is at two hull and one's at full, of course.
Yeah, the one that nobody shot at.
Oh, you already put it in there. All right, never mind.
I didn't write them short and tall for...
Oh, they want that. Look, after they're next turn, guys, so it's not going to matter, so don't worry about it. So, yeah, so needy.
Frank is a cheater. You heard it here first.
Yes. Yep.
You should have one more damage on
you know, a good way to win games, Paul, is to just cheat.
Yeah.
Frank just forgot to take the extra shield off tomorrow.
Yeah, he should have one hole left on his scout rather than two. What?
Oh, he didn't spend the focus. Okay.
Oh, he didn't spend the focus. Oh.
Okay, so Frank is, cheat better.
Frank is not a cheater. He's just we misunderstood what was happening. Yeah.
Which was ballsy.
shot the second back door, shot the front one, the front scout at Nora, fired the torque.
Yeah.
Did two damage. Two shields off. There was a plasma torque.
Oh, they missed the extra shield. Gotcha.
Yeah. Is that a May effect?
No.
No, that's not a May effect.
I'll double check right now, but I don't think
if that's not a May effect, you should probably mention it to a judge to go wander over. If it's not a May effect, you should probably mention it to a judge,
okay.
Chris, to go wander over there. And
Tony, one sec. I got it right here.
Just check to see if it's a May effect.
No, remove one damage. It's not a May.
Not a May.
So mention it to Chris. He's not actually a cheater. In fact, he's just bad at knowing what his ability
cards
are.
No, internet, get ready. Frank's cheating. And so is John. Ready your pitchforks. Funny, they just had that conversation right before the game.
Yeah. Okay, so Nora is at 6 holes, 0 shields.
Yep. Appreciate it.
Okay, so Frank's about to lose a scout.
Yes. Would you bother trying to block it off the board? Or trying to block it for the console fire with Jess?
I'm not sure if there's a good reason to.
I don't know. I don't know what else Jess does, though. What's Nora tall mean? There's two arcs. One's tall and one is short. Nora is the tall one. So John was successful, though, in making Frank split his fire, which is absolutely not what he wants to do.
Yeah, yep.
So, and so, all right, you're a rebel player.
Uh-huh.
So I'm a swarm player. I take Jess and I two turn, but that gets rid of a third of your shots just to block Finn.
Yeah, no, you just go one forward.
Just go one forward?
Yeah.
But you don't get actions. I mean, you don't get to go the other way either, but then Finn gets actions.
Whatever, you got your rerolls and...
Yeah, it's fine. It's all fine.
Actually, you might be right with how badly hurt she is. You probably want to block Finn. That's probably the right choice.
But then if you two turn, it's not like that's green, so...
Whatever.
Do you know what they're hitting that's knocking the camera? Like, is it, like, the feet under the table or something?
I don't know.
Not anywhere near it. It's the ghost of Aaron Utley.
I think they're bumping the table slightly.
Oh, okay.
Because the table is basically like a card table. Yes. It's not, like, a very solid table.
Not like this table.
Yeah.
As the monitor shakes. Okay, I'll stop.
It's not... So, you weren't here for Bobblehead Ghost... So someone had a ghost on an epic template or an epic stand.
Just on the one.
Every time anything happened, he just started bobbling back and forth.
Making everyone nervous.
We're like, is it going to go? Is it gonna, like the entire
are we
game?
Lose it?
Entire game, he's bobbling back
did
and forth.
Did it never fall?
No, it never fell.
Just did R3A2. That's why all the ships are stressed.
Yes,
that's the exclamation mark dice.
Of R3A2, yeah.
Which means if that scout sloops, it doesn't get to flip over its console fire.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, it's probably going to want to do a left turn, oddly enough. So,
right.
Yeah, you're probably right with the two right there, or maybe even a three.
If you do the two, you might block Finn as well, which is nice.
Yeah.
And if you block that front jump, you definitely block the back jump.
Yeah, it's just a mess. Absolute mess.
But Nora will still get her actions, don't worry.
Yeah.
Nora's her 18
crazy.
Actions.
Yeah, she'll have an evade, a focus, like
target lock,
other,
a barrel
yeah.
roll,
yeah.
and be like, "All right, I guess my action bar's done now."
Yeah, I'm out.
That's all of them. Yeah, I don't like Finn Rao doesn't have any good moves this turn.
Oh yeah, the stress on Jess that does kind of blend in.
Yeah, with the mat, with the beautiful Steel Open mat.
Steel Open 2017 mat, yeah.
Do we have an artist we can plug for the Steel Open mat?
I'm sure there is one, but I don't know.
No, Aaron made it. So Jess chooses the one bank. Oh, that's good. That blocks everything as well. It won't block Finn, but he might be blocking Finn with other ships.
Trying to do some blocking and still get a shot on the back contracted scout, looks like.
Yep. Or Finn, if Finn decides to take that to... No. No shot on Finn.
Back jump master we're starting with.
Uh-oh. Interesting. I wonder what the front's maneuver is that he'd rather bump than clear that... Is he just trying to block Shara on the rock, maybe?
Yeah, I'm not sure what the goal there is. Yeah, you should mark a ship.
So it looks like he called the block. Would the two-turn have blocked that? I don't think so.
Two-turn would not have blocked his forward move now. That's fine to get in the little hole in between them.
Yep. Unfortunately for Frank, all these ships have rear arcs.
Yes. I mean, that ship's still going to die. But
yes.
Are there still any Imperialists? No.
No.
Flip console fire.
Oh, Frank, you got to believe in the dice gods.
Yeah.
Don't worry, I'm sure he blocked Nora.
I mean, he might have. She'll only get, like, three actions instead of four. Whoa. Big boof.
So it looks like Jess will be dying to Fenrau this turn. Well, two straight, maybe not. Just kidding. All right, Whisper, where are you going?
Yeah, you got your BB-8 in action.
Frank goes, oh, that's not going to work. Oh, wait, you get baby BB-8. Whoops. Was it a one straight, did you see? One bank?
I'm assuming it's one bank.
Because he actually... Oh, he'll still have a shot to kill it. Never mind. Just kidding. So he could barrel... So he barrel rolled back there? Or
barrel back there, yeah. He's probably trying to get as much of an arc
I'm
as
curious
possible.
If, so that... Because if he barrel rolled here and one bank there...
So you know he's playing against your list, right?
Jeremy, yeah?
He no fucks behind Miranda, through a cluster mine, doesn't roll any damage, five dice, kills Miranda.
Oh, well, he won.
So when Duncan's not at a tournament, Jeremy Hauer gets his plot armor, apparently.
Yes, apparently.
Oh, wow, it's two bank.
Yeah, that's okay.
So who did he target lock?
The back.
Okay.
Guy.
He's not worrying about Finn still.
The T-70 is a...
Frank's like, how do you get all these actions?
So, from getting... And, does... Let's see, and Shara's over there. Okay, yeah. These are not a bad position for him.
No. Especially not next turn. That jump muster is not moving next turn.
Yeah. Okay, Finn's just going too forward.
Yep, and won't have arc on Jess.
No, that does not have arc on Jess.
And will probably just focus for everybody, I assume.
Yep. It's just, yeah,
it's
going to
shoot range 2 at an evaded arc, which is really going to do a lot, I'm sure.
It's gonna shoot Nora. Nora has 6 hull left, so she's probably fine.
Probably a shield, I assume he regen. Well, oh, that's not
Nora doesn't
I'm
have dumb. The R2-D2. Yes, Nora did bump, but yet, even though she bumped, she still gets an evade token and a target lock because she's awesome.
Oh, Fenrau.
So, hit crit.
What's it going to be?
Hit crit into
big
old
Nora.
What's
in the box?
Console fire for you, too.
Extremely not relevant for her. I don't think she's shy on actions.
Yeah. Well, you can't clear the console fire in a push.
I'm sure you're going to block her.
So butt shot from...
Hey, hit crit. That title is really good.
That was fun, yeah. So a blank here means Scout dies. Scout
there
dies.
Which means that Jess survives. Probably. So you'd have to take 3 with 2 rerolls to die, which would be impressive.
Do you take the range 2 shot on Fen? No,
know.
You have a target lock on the other guy.
Did he shoot out of order? No,
he shot
they're
out
both
of the
7. They're both 7.
Yeah.
I'm dumb.
Obstructed 2.
I mean, range 2 shot on Fen? It's no mods, but...
I think that's probably obstructed.
It looks obstructed. John sounds like he doesn't really have a target priority here. He just wants to do some damage with this shot.
Yeah, he just wants to do damage.
There it is, going for the scout. Probably the correct decision. Still can't decide.
And I would check Jess just to make sure she doesn't have an arc on
It looks like she does. She's like, if she were straight, I think she wouldn't, but that weird angle she's got, I don't know.
Yep.
Scout it is.
Going at the scout.
Hey.
Nice, nice.
Here comes Frank's three natural evades calling it now. I was close. Keeps the focus, wants the target lock next turn.
Shooting at Jess.
So sounds like they didn't even bother measuring Jess, so it must be clear that she doesn't have arc. There's three into Jess. Hey, two evades. Jess Pava doing Jess Pava things.
Yep.
Taking one.
So Jess only takes one. One hole left.
Power, man. Fucking Jerry. Heard Kim Taro's game over, right?
What?
Yeah. Came over, right?
And got a crit that when he does a white, he takes stress.
On Jess?
On Jess.
That is very relevant.
I would measure Jess just to make sure she didn't have a shot.
I mean, you could argue it's a missed opportunity at this point, but Frank just kind of went off, and I also don't think Frank would do that.
Just measure. Just see if there's even a shot.
Yep. It's like,
shoot. Just shoot. Oh my god, just shoot. Just shoot. Just shoot. Just shoot. Just shoot.
Just shoot.
If there is a shot, take it.
At least just check, guys.
Measure
the
damn arc. Measure the arc. It's step one, measure the arc. Yeah, just take the damn shot. Take the shot. Take the shot. Frank, just tell him to take the shot.
Seriously.
Come on, Frank.
What's happening?
My list is moving around.
Oh.
Let him take the shot. Let him take the shot. Come on, Frank. Just let him take the shot. Frank, you were the one that told him to not take the shot, Frank.
Is it time to get the pitchforks, Paul?
Oh, get the pitchforks. Take the shot.
Paul, fuck your list.
Hey. Take your shot. Take your shot. Take the shot. Take the shot. Take the shot.
So they're just going to back the whole game state up, which is needlessly complicated, but whatever.
What the?
Which still works in Frank's favor because that shot onto Jess probably should do more than one damage on average.
Okay, they're just reshuffling the thing. Oh my god.
And here's where you also ask the judge for more time now. Oh, thank you.
You guys watch Futurama?
Yes. Sweet. Which one do you want, Paul?
Oh, B.
B it is. Probably the correct choice. That's awesome.
Okay.
Oh, is there also a C? Wait, what's happening?
Oh, well, that's to Aaron.
Oh, gotcha.
Okay, so they went back in time.
Yes.
He took the shot, did two shields to the scout, stressed the two people, and they're redoing the, redoing this.
Oh, Frank.
You should have just kept away. Reroll. And
so John comes out very ahead from this.
Oh, Okay, I think they have figured it out.
Jeremy, he's on my way home. I'm on his way home. He just does that. I go, okay.
Oh yeah, he might. Did he forget to use his Jess ability on the Jess shot?
I wasn't watching.
Everything was so dramatic.
We got distracted.
There. Yeah. Scum players are so scummy.
Yeah, seriously. At least they're not terrorists, Paul.
Nobody cares. That's right. Frank saying when he watches the stream afterwards, he turns the volume off so he doesn't have to hear what we're saying about him.
We'll just go tell him what we said the whole time afterwards. I like how everyone assumes we're much meaner than we are.
Yeah, I mean we're
honestly you put me back here so I can see it.
We're pretty, you know, we're not like launching a bunch of expletives around or anything.
Yeah.
Other than when Jeremy comes up and starts screaming about my list.
Yep.
That
Speaking
is a
of
shame
terrorists.
That it didn't beat him. I was really rooting for my list to just crush him, but. Oh well.
Maybe some people get to have fun in their X-Wing game now. No, never mind. It's Mind Link everywhere.
We could see John can make it through.
I think John's going to win this game.
He'll be our true hope. Yeah, he still has his regenerator.
Yeah. And that regenerator is worth more points than Finn Rout, and they killed like 30 minutes on that shot. So, at least I assume that regenerator is worth more than Finn Rout.
Probably.
I have the list right here.
It's not like you don't have the list right there.
I do have the list right here. Finn Rout's 32.
Yep.
Jeremy's just regaling his epic tale of one-shotting a Miranda to everyone. Or one-turning.
Yep.
Yes, Alex, I assume that Frank is not rooting for John here. Though, actually, he kind of was earlier.
I think Frank is rooting for John, actually. Are you guys, are they putting down dials? Like, what are they doing here?
I have
We're
no
just
idea.
Hanging. I think they're just having a conversation
they're
over
probably
there.
Just having fun.
Like, oh, I guess we have to play this game.
Well, I can see why they're taking a while to set dials here, to be fair. What a mess. What does Finn Rao even do?
Why does each turn take forever? I don't know. We're asking the same question. What are they doing?
Finn Rao has to do a green move. I guess he doesn't. Yes, he does. All right, it's happening.
Oh,
Jess.
We're starting again. We have.
So Jess no longer has to do a white maneuver, take a crit?
Yeah, she no longer has that.
Okay. We have wound back in time.
Yeah. We do have... Nora still has a console fire.
So X-Wing have the 3 Talon roll. Is that even good next turn?
He could boost after it.
That is very good next turn. Because you'll be behind Finn Rao with a stressor.
Yep. Getting your stress hog behind Finn Rao is
yes.
pretty good.
Sadly, it's only single stress, but it looks like pretty soon this Jumpmaster is about to get lit up.
Yep.
And single action Finn Rao is, I believe, the worst Finn Rao.
I'm kind of assuming Finn Rao's running here.
I mean, the best he can run is like a 3 straight or a 2 turn out, but there's rear arcs, so there's not really any running.
That's true, yeah. And here's BB-8 shenanigans.
What's happening? God only knows.
Yeah.
It's not even worth trying to guess where he's going to be.
He's going to be somewhere.
Probably going to block the one turn for Finn, is my assumption.
No, I did not play in the tournament. No, you know you don't.
No, what?
You can't push the limit to action console fire down because you only push the limit to get an action off your thing.
So fine. I'll actually clear my new maneuver for console fire. Yeah. Fine. Oh, yeah.
Ridge.
I'm surprised it's not a bank to block Fin Rao's stuff, but I guess if he two turns Fin Rao in, he's happy about that.
Don't make it a flex. Make it an evade. Evade. Yeah. I have no idea if that's the right choice.
But it's cool.
Yeah. It's cool to use your abilities.
One, two, three, four actions? Is
yeah,
that
hit
right?
Four actions,
okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Just a couple.
Four action Nora is the best Nora.
Could you make it five? Can we make it jankier?
We probably could, but.
Oh, yeah, Finn. That's not where you want to be. Not that it was the wrong move to set. It's just not where he wants to
probably,
be.
Probably a focus probably would have been the smarter move on Nora rather than getting the evade, but. Because he's probably still shooting out Jess Bava. But.
Would you like to stay range one in my rear arc, Fin Rao? He
yeah,
would.
That
he would.
He's all in.
Does that arc have... I don't think he has arc on the ship he target locked.
No. No, he doesn't.
I do like the evade more, though, because unless he rolls double focus out the rear...
Yeah, that's true. You still got...
I mean, you probably want the target lock on...
What?
The dream. Four blanks. All right. He tried. He did his best to plank out.
He tried hard to fail. Okay. I like these arcs. They're
yeah,
neat.
This is working pretty well.
Oh, he just rolled both dice. When you spend a target lock, for future reference, when you have eyeball and blank with...
Is that... I don't know if I believe you. I thought it was if you had two blanks and an eyeball. Is it one?
With one blank and one eyeball, when you're turning one of your eyeballs to a crit, I would reroll both.
There's a correct answer. Somebody knows.
Definitely the correct answer.
Bob, if you're still in the chat, what's the correct answer? I thought it was two blanks. It's like, if you're rerolling three dice, you throw the eyeball in. But I also don't play rack, so... It rarely comes up.
Okay, this is just Pava trying to survive. Is she within range one of her buddy?
Oh, yeah. Wow.
She has an eyeball.
Oh, taking a damage. Crit?
So here comes a crit.
Oh, the hit goes...
Wait,
what?
Just, you're dodging one of them.
Their brains are broken. Do you hear them, R2? They're dying.
They're dying in there. So just a crit. Blind a pilot.
That's which, fine.
Well, yep. So Jess is blind for next turn.
Oh, no, no.
Jess is popping
pitching
the
astromech.
So. Because, yeah, she's doing a
yeah, she's doing roll. The talent roll.
Yeah.
Just having those talent rolls on your dial is so much better than just the K turns.
Yeah.
If Jess were a lowly stress hog here, she'd be stuck two turning into oblivion. I mean, now she doesn't have a stressor at all, but she does still have a gun.
So, oh, I forgot. Did the scouts actually take damage?
I'll go check.
I missed it.
Hey, Travis. Can you go check how much health that scout has? The one that's alive.
The dead one is dead.
He would come back and tell us that the one was dead had 9 damage on it. I don't doubt it.
Four action Nora is actually pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'm a fan.
Okay, so it took a shield.
Did it take a shield? Okay.
Does he have a bid for PS7? Because old Tarok's out there, and he is not... He looks at all your actions and says, no, sir.
You still get to have your target lock and your barrel roll, so you're only two actions then.
And you get the focus out of the rear arc, as my Carter Jacks learned the very sad way.
Yes. Okay, so Fin Rao is still fine. Scout's almost at half. Nora's on 4, and Jess is on actual 2.
So he's at 99, which is probably right. Trying to bid against Tarok is a very losing game. Mm-hmm.
We have 30 minutes remaining in the round. Oh, they say they're going to be dumb long before that, but I don't know.
I think we're going to have a lot of Finral flying against Shara.
Yeah. You think it makes sense not to use the focus? Well, you certainly don't use it. Well,
yeah, but not before.
Well, I mean, there's no reason. Well, I mean, it doesn't really matter all that much.
Yeah, okay. Take that, Paul. Me and Bob agree against you. Both from memory, so it's definitely correct. There it is. So fancy.
Prime thrusters after the Talon roll. I like that.
It's very cool.
Yeah.
What's that, Paul? The magic number is 3 rerolls? is that what chat's saying? I think that's what chat's saying.
Fine.
Frank going for the block on BB-8 Dara. I don't know if I believe Frank.
He might have it.
John has to one straight for him to not, I think, and even that might do it. Or he could like 3 bank right and just kill him.
Whoa! Oh, she's doing a 4K.
That is not what I expected.
I did not expect it either.
Rebel players and their K turns.
We do like our K turns. But like all 4 of your actions go away.
It's like the first couple games I played Finral, I looked at the T rolls and the K turns and was like, wait, I can do these. These are legal maneuvers. Uh-oh. Oh. John, keep your ship on air. You got it. Wow. Fancy.
I think he has nothing.
Yeah, he doesn't have anything. But it cleared. So that's cool.
Okay. I mean, you don't really have a ton of actions to take a shower, so... Get a target lock? Yeah.
Yep. Focus isn't going to do you any good on one die.
Yeah.
He's about to roll a focus, but...
No one's shooting a Chara.
Yeah.
I am surprised you did that 4K there.
Yeah, me too. Okay, Finral did do the T-roll, as to be expected.
Okay, some the other X-Wing stuff is at time, not us.
So he could drop Prime Thrusters... Oh, for Auto Thrusters. Probably not worth it.
I do love Auto Thrusters.
Auto Thrusters is a pretty good card, as it turns out. But it would be very good here. Finn rolls 2. He's got 3 and a reroll. Oh, reroll.
Take a reroll. Take the reroll. Take the reroll. 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 Reroll a die. There you go. Yep. One. And one hole left on Jess.
So Auto Thrusters would have made that 0. So Auto Thrusters, he wouldn't have had the boost, so the shot wouldn't have happened.
The funniest thing is, he wouldn't have been boosting, so he wouldn't have been shot at all.
But also, he would have taken one more damage from a previous shot because of, what's it called? Because of integrated.
Oh, they're checking. Yeah, definitely out. Range 1 into the scout.
Ooh.
He's 3 hits. Do you have a target lock? And to nothing. His target locks have not really done much.
He did the first one he spent did something. Ho!
What are you doing? Come on.
Frank, practice pays off.
Yeah.
Yes, Nathan, John has a 1-point bid in his list, so he can drop Prime Thrusters for Auto Thrusters.
Come on, Jess.
Four die and a reroll. Let's see how it goes. Oh,
yeah, not bad.
Pretty good.
Good reroll.
Hey-o, there it is. So fancy.
Yeah, spent char base lock and gets another 2 in.
Yep.
So Scott has 2 hole left.
No, he's taking 3.
Oh, he's taking 3. Scott has 1 hole left.
Yeah, he wants to kill Jess.
Yeah.
Understandably so.
You do want to take a ship off the board at some point.
Yes. Oh, Frank. Try again, Frank. What do you got?
Focus and spend the target lock that he got.
Hey!
And that'll do it.
Reroll it. Do it anyway. Yeah, there we go.
That's an interesting assault by Flying Monkey. To, you add a focus and you reroll it. Like, you go all in on Nora's attack.
Oh, that would have done it, wouldn't it?
Okay, so we've got a dead Jess Papa. We got Nora down to half, not that that matters. Sharabay still at full with her regeneration abilities. And we got Fen Rao and an almost dead scout. So the almost dead scout is going to be a dead scout very soon.
Oh, yeah. He'll give Fen Rao a focus, though. That's about it.
Yes. Your job is to give Fen Rao a focus.
Actually, will he? They can't. He has no green moves. You're useless, scout. You are completely and totally useless. You can try to block Nora with BB-8.
Well, she's not going to do it because she's stressed. Like, I really don't know why he did that 4K. I mean, I guess he did still get a shot, which, like, a lot of the other things that he would have been able to do would not have gotten a shot, so.
Yep. Because the one straight was risky.
Yeah.
That scout can block a lot of things here, too.
Yep.
Like, everything.
Well, his two ships go at the two arcs go at the same pilot skill, yeah, so he can kind of monkey around with things and do things in whatever order he needs. I think his main goal here is not to get Nora killed by Fen Rao this turn.
Ooh, I thought that was going to be a one turn. Just in front of everything. That actually looks better now that I look at it, though. Because now it's, if he self-bumps that arc, the back one, it might not even have arc. It's close.
And now he's trying to figure out, will my arc...
Yeah. The three straight green on the arc dial.
Oh, he's doing a one straight on the arc. Pump that in.
Oh, yeah, I don't think he'll have arc there. Oh, ooh, yeah, he does. Maybe?
Maybe? You're already touching.
Hey! Well, now he might not have arc. Frank's Chuck Master got knocked a good, like, few millimeters there. By John, against his own favor. So yeah, it's like he's cheating or anything.
Yeah, he was cheating in Frank's favor, so we're cool with that. But he does get a free evade out of it. Because
of reasons.
I mean, being able to spam evades, like, fairly regularly,
pretty good.
That's strong. Looks like Shire's finally going to start getting shot at.
Yep. I'm sure this is going to be relevant. This two damage she takes here.
Yeah. Or they just move the ship's turn.
Yeah, just keep pushing it forward. Oh, range two, what do you know, Fen Rao? Isn't that unfortunate? Spend it, Frank.
Scoop those up, put them back.
That's not what Jeremy does.
I'm gonna give out a pop team. Okay, so Shara is able to shoot. Oh, Shara. Shara just drops the scout, no matter what he rolls.
Savage.
Full set,
if you want. Yeah, go for it. We got plenty.
One of the guys I played yesterday was really cool.
Loses his other scout.
Hanging out with him for a couple minutes.
Nice.
Ooh. Frank shows his Polish double damage. Yep. That's the card that he drew there.
Is that legal?
Yeah.
Okay.
I will make it legal.
That's fair. I am the Senate. I mean, everyone does it.
Yeah.
Well, not everyone, but a lot of people have, you know, like different language damage decks.
Yeah.
For direct hits, because, you know.
And also a nothing. So both of those guys just flail at each other.
Oh.
Okay, so this is where Fenrao is going against two Arc 170s.
Yep. All
right, guys. See y'all later in podcast land.
How is Nora getting evades? Nora wills them into existence.
Yeah. Nora just grabs a handful of tokens and throws them down.
These are mine now.
Yeah. It's my tokens.
Are we going to see Nora not BB-8? Is that legal? Because he can just one straight and it's hilarious.
I think just, yeah, going forward. You know, I would consider like doing like a longer forward, maybe?
Yeah, like just let Finn get behind you. Because then he doesn't get his title.
Yeah.
And you don't have Tail Gunner, but... Yeah, if you, like, what, three straight? And
yeah,
then one
like
bank
a
or
longer
something?
Straight? Yeah, just so... Because you don't want Finn to just go two straight and light you up.
Yeah.
So you want to make sure that that doesn't happen. Well, I thank you for saying that his commentary is outstanding. We're doing a great job.
I take full responsibility.
So I would do at least a two straight.
Yeah. Got to go faster than one.
But we do have an ability to use... We have to use it.
It's like Riyadh. Like, I did a five straight. The five straight's better. Now we're going to K-turn anyways.
We've got an ability. We're going to use it.
Actually, well, here he can do the two bank, because that's green. And that gives him the same thing, but now he can push and not be
stressed. Same basic idea. Now he gets, cool push the limit actions and everything. Yeah. It's probably better to do it this way. But
we look... We're funny when we make fun of him for it, so it's fine.
Yeah.
Oh, it's one bank.
He probably still blocks it too forward.
Yeah, I think
so. Yeah, he still blocks it too forward.
It's really close, though. Oh. Focus token, not an action, he says.
Why would you not give yourself the evade there?
I think he's going to take a focus action to get the evade. I don't know. He has no other action.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know why the order matters.
Okay.
But
I guess it doesn't matter which order you do that in, but yeah, it's...
And Fenrao will be running into the Jaws of Death here, unless that bumps, in which case, that's silly. Yeah.
No, that cleared.
Yep.
Nice, nice.
Yeah, very nice. Yeah. He's done that twice now. You can call one an accident. Oh, you can call two an accident, too. Never mind.
And he did do the two straight.
Oh, savage.
Yeah, that...
Oh.
That was close.
Everyone clinch. Yeah.
Yeah, you're hitting there.
Frank? Oh.
Yep.
Wow. Not even close.
Well, Shara's getting shot at.
Yes.
She's full and she regenerates, so...
Yes, I doubt he cares
much. It's not the end of the world getting shot at.
And Finn has no actions. He only gets one free evade. If you roll three or four hits, he's suddenly scared. Fenrao, you are bad.
Fenrao.
Fine, I'll take two shields.
Two shields.
The dream. Round two.
Try again. That's much better.
Hey, there you go. That might actually be damage. Half
and
the time.
Four dice plus a free evade.
Not so much.
Is three.
Fenrao, that's a good Soon Jafel impersonation, but you can't keep it up. So both these ships are worth more than Finn.
Yeah.
As
so Finn
would
has to kill both of those ships.
Yes, in like 20 minutes.
Something like that.
And Frank did not get a time extension for his like 20-minute judge call. So.
I mean, with all these butt arcs and everything, like I don't know where he goes to not get shot. Like,
yeah.
At range twos.
It's
like stuff's gonna
I'm
get
looking
in.
At him like 4K.
Yeah, just do the 4K and be like.
At least he'll be range three.
Yeah.
Like, every other maneuver he has is worse. The 4K is still bad.
4K, at least he'll be able to shoot some more at Nora, who's going to have an evade token and
focus
and
rage 3. You got it, Finn.
I like this. I like this
Nora. Yeah, I'm in for this plan.
Yeah.
You can do a damage if you just roll 3 naturals. Easy. Yeah, I like that people complain about Itani action economy, like me, look at this board and go, okay, so John gets 5 actions a turn, maybe 6, and Frank gets 1.
Yep. Now they're bad-mouthing us on the board.
Aaron, it's not. You said there was no crash prize.
He did say that. I was there. I witnessed.
I did go 0-6 in Destiny with the self-mill deck.
And they couldn't.
I know, but now I need to defend myself. I went 0-6 with the self-mill deck. It was fun. Aaron said there was no crash prize, so I wasn't going to feel bad about taking from somebody that actually lost. And then Aaron gives me a crash prize. So thank you, Aaron, but come on, Aaron.
What are you doing? Oh, my God, don't take...
What are you still doing here? No. I'm sure they had it.
So I think Nora runs out of actions before she, like, that she can physically take before she runs out of the ability to take actions here.
Yes.
Like,
he didn't regen a shield. This game's over.
Put the shield on. Put the shield on.
No, he did it 2 turns.
Oh. Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I like how you just assume. At least I think it was a 2 turn, right? Yeah. Chat. To yell at me if I'm wrong.
That was 2 bank that he did.
Oh, was it? Okay.
Yeah. Wow, he... Yeah, it's... Okay, yep.
Setting up some butt shots.
Yep. Oh, wow. I wasn't expecting him to be over there. Like, if Fed does, like,
neither.
A 1-left turn here...
I didn't even think he could get over there.
Oh, he did forget to regenerate.
Oh, okay. John, very honest, goes, I forgot to regen a shield, missed opportunity. Doesn't even ask for it.
Yeah.
Yep, it's a 4K. I assume.
Yeah.
A 4 straight would be a very weird choice.
Yeah, the 1 turn would have... just happened to work out well.
Yeah,
here,
but it was bad unless very specific things happened.
Unless this happened, yeah. Because I was expecting more of a 2 bank from Nora there.
You don't want to be blocked like behind 2 arcs at range 1? That seems fun without them in arc.
Oh, hey, nice roll there. Unfortunately, only 1 crit gets in. No, 1 crit. 1.
It's on. Ooh, there's a really important one. So
these
it's
guys
not
are
a
so tired.
It's a direct. So she's down to 2.
Okay. So he took a direct hit.
Yeah.
As they realize what's going on. Oh, we've seen worse.
Yeah, no. You can go back and watch the top 8 last year. I can promise you there's worse play in it.
Some range 2 butt shots into Fen.
Yep. Ho! Oh. Yeah.
Yeah. Add an eyeball and
make
turn
it a crit, baby.
Yes.
Good luck, Fen.
Here's Fen's naked dice.
Yep.
Oh. Straight up took it off to the face.
Oh, it's range 2?
It's range 2.
Savage.
Dead.
Wrecked.
Straight up, Frank just explodes there.
Damaged engine, direct.
Oh, man. Okay, so yeah, that's that.
Yep. Arcs are in the top four. Paul,
I'm pretty happy with that.
Remember when I was complaining last night that I can't play Imperials and never get shot? Mm-hmm. If I can play Arcs, I'm happy.
Arcs are solid. Okay, well, that is the round. We're just about done with time. I think we're going to go in the top 4 real soon now. So, We'll be here in a little bit. See everybody later.
Yep, thanks for watching, everybody.